Welcome back to Let's Code. Today we are talking about particle effects on the GPU with Bevy 0.9. Now, Bevy 0.9 came out very recently, so while the ecosystem is updating, it sort of happens in a wave. So while we wait for things like Bevy Rapier, which are almost ready, but not quite, we can take a look at other crates that have updated and some of which have changed their APIs. Bevy Hanabi is one such crate that we use in the Blockbreaker game on this channel. In this case, we've got an example that is a point that is rotating around what looks like an infinity sign, and it's spawning particles as it goes that live for a specified lifetime and then get removed. Now, the Bevy Hanabi APIs are largely built around giving you a nice interface to programming GPU-based particle effects. The API goes something like this. You create an effect asset. You define what happens for the initialization phase. You define what happens every frame to update the state, and then you define how they render. Once you've created this particle effect, you can use it as part of a particle effect bundle, which gets its own transform and things like that. So you could imagine, similar to the way that in Hollow Knight, maybe you walk along the ground and leaves kick up behind you, we could do that with this library. Similarly, in Blockbreaker, whenever we hit a block or a wall, we spawn some particles that fade away over time. Now, some other ecosystem crates have already updated, like Bevy Inspector GUI, so those crates are also being used in this example. The most important symbols that we bring in are from the Bevy Hanabi prelude. If you're unfamiliar with what preludes are, they're basically a bunch of symbols and functions and things that you can use that the creator of the crate thinks 80%, let's say, of applications will want to use. So they're usually really good for getting started. They're really good for building out new features. And sometimes you cull them back when you go to production and only import what you need. So our Bevy app starts off by setting some WGPU settings. Specifically, we're setting the vertex writable storage setting to true, which lets us bind writable buffers to our vertex shader. When we create our Bevy application, we insert that resource, which configures WGPU for us. We're setting some logging levels here, so we do get some output in the console if you run this on your own. We've got a system that will close the example when you hit escape. We've got the Hanabi plugin itself, which powers all the GPU particle effects. We've got the World Inspector plugin, which will bring up an eGUI inspector to show us what's going on in our scene and the entities that are available. We've got a setup system and an update system. The setup system only runs once and is responsible for setting up the effect that we talked about earlier. So we need to define what kind of effect we are actually going to use as our particle effect when we spawn it. So in this case, we're creating a 3D camera bundle so that we can see things in our scene. And we're creating an effect asset with a particular texture that we've pulled in through the asset system in Bevy and a color over lifetime modifier, which allows us to pass in a gradient with keys from 0 to 1. So this gradient is defined from 0 to 1 at any number of steps and defines the color over the lifetime of the particle, which is why it's linearized. It's from 0 to 1. It's not from like 0 to 5 or some other arbitrary number. You can think of this as 0% to 100%. In this case, we're starting off with everything at 1. So RGBA, all 1. And then we remove one set of colors and then two sets of colors and then all sets of colors, including the alpha. We're using a cloud.png for the texture handle that we pass to the effect. So you can use your own images here, which means that you can spawn particles that look like whatever you want them to look like. And each particle will get that image applied when it's spawned. Then we spawn in the effect with the particle effect bundle and give it children of a cube. And that's the cube that's going to go in the infinity symbol. Since this particle effect always runs, this is all we really need to do to get the particles to start firing from the cube. If we go back up to the effect asset itself, we can see that the spawner is set at a rate of 1,000. So this is just constantly sending out more particles. If you're really into the math of how the infinity symbol is drawn, there's a lemniscate function here that defines that infinity symbol based on the radius and a time. It's really just some math and you can do whatever you want here, so I'm not really going to go over it. And then finally, our update system is responsible for moving the cube around the scene. So we're querying for the time resource here, as well as any entity that has a transform with a particle effect component on it. So if you're unfamiliar with Bevy queries, this query will give us a mutable reference to the transform for this entity, and we are filtering for entities that have the particle effect component, but we aren't retrieving the particle effect component. In this case, in our update function, we don't need it because remember the particle is constantly firing in this example. We've got a couple of consts here, alpha offset and speed offset. We loop over all the transforms that we get from this query up here and note that we're iterating mutably because we're going to mutate that transform. We do some calculations to calculate what the alpha should be and what the radius is going to be. And we call this lemniscate function to define where the cube is inside of that infinity symbol that we saw earlier. That gives us back the vector that we need to pass into the translation of the transform. So we can just set that and it'll move the cube around the screen. So if we go back and we watch the output here, what we end up with is this cube that's moving around the screen, a particles that are coming off of it at a rate of 1,000, moving in a transform based on wherever the cube is. So the particles spawn wherever the cube is, and then they live for a number of seconds or whatever, and then they get removed. Or rather, they fade out from pure white, as you can see right at the core of the cube, all the way down until the alpha is zero. So that's particle effects with Bevy Hanabi in Bevy 0.9. If you haven't used Bevy Hanabi before, there won't be any obvious changes to you, obviously, because you haven't used it. But that init update render API that we looked at earlier is the change here. So I hope you enjoyed this video on particle systems in Bevy 0.9 with Bevy Hanabi, and I'll catch you in the next video. Have a great day.